Well, here's my short edition of the Halloween edition that I do every year of finding yourself with ADD. So instead of scaring yourself, you're going to find some new ways to wish yourself and vision yourself into the kind of life that you want. And today we're just going to talk about what happens when you run into those bumps in the road. I've talked to a lot of people recently about what's their adversity style. What happens when you run into those inevitable struggles and challenges? Everybody, I found out, has their own unique approach to this, and it's really important for you to figure out what's your adversity style so you know it's going to kick in when you hit some kind of challenge. At first you might be scared, but if you've thought this through and even put it up on your wall and you remember, oh yeah, in the end, what usually keeps me going is my analytical ability, as one woman said, or another woman discovered it was really her courage. Not that she wasn't afraid, but that eventually she got out of bed and she found a way to mobilize resources around her and face her challenges in a new and creative way. Each of you, whether it's determination or humor or the love you have around you, each of you has a style that kicks in. So I want you to spend some time thinking about what is your adversity style, so when you get scared, you can remember, oh, I might be scared now, but I know who I am as a person is somebody who has perseverance or who thinks about problems in a creative way. And you can relax and know that eventually you'll get through this. You know, people say, well, I had no choice afterwards looking back. And it's not true. People make choices all the time to not keep going forward, to just stay in bed and pull the covers over their head or to give up. So you do have choice, and you have to realize that's a strength and that you do have coping mechanisms that are characteristic of you that kick in. And that's my Halloween message this weekend before Halloween, about not scaring yourself. The other lesson is about taking that mask off and taking that risk to let people see who you are and know who you are, and to move a little bit closer toward not hiding who you are. Not just telling everybody you have ADD, but not hiding what you think or you feel or your interesting differences. Other people might actually relate to those and see you as an individual. And that's what you have to give to people. Your individuality, your differences can be a gift to other people. So let me just see a few of the questions I had this week from people and see if any of this fits into our theme here. One is someone wrote in who's entrepreneur who's afraid that his customers are all going to all of a sudden leave him, and he's starting to panic. You know, it's funny, I know that so many people with ADD have had a lot of experiences of failure in the past, or of being scolded, or of people not being happy with their performance from time to time. And what happens is when we see these subtle little signs now, the fear kicks in and we begin to read all sorts of things that are sort of normal, that people have different experiences of you, and some are really happy with you and some are not that pleased, and that's normal. But when you have ADD and some of these early experiences, this feeling of negative expectations or panic or what's wrong with me kicks in. And what happens is then you start to send subtle messages to your customers or to your friends or your loved ones that I'm not good enough, or you're right, you shouldn't really hang around here, or I know you're going to leave anyway, just get it over with. So sometimes, and then when it happens, it's not really because of you and the original issue maybe you have, but it's these subtle messages that you're giving off about I'm not good enough, you might as well just leave. So do some checks when you are starting to feel this way, and make sure you're not giving off the stay away, push other people away before they hurt you message, because you might be having a self-fulfilling prophecy. Then there's another young man who writes in from time to time. This time he's talking about going country dancing with his friends. And this person has worked for a long time on having relationships and getting out there, which is great. But now he slips into this feeling of, oh, what's wrong with me? I'm so awkward. I feel so guilty. I'm ruining everybody's time, because when they say go left, I go right. And so he feels actually bad and guilty that he has to practice so much, that other people get these things so much easier. You know, and of course it's awkward and it's frustrating, but the telling point is that he feels actually guilty or ashamed that he's not picking this up as easy as other people. And again, this is about perfectionism, about having this yardstick, this false idea of perfection. And again, a lot of ADD individuals I talk to have this fantasy or just no idea of what it means to be in that normal range. They think, well, no one else makes mistakes. Everybody else gets these moves perfectly. Nobody else struggles. And so it's just because, like, if you've always had a weight issue, you think, oh, well, to be thin, everything's wonderful in those people's lives. Or if you've struggled with money, you think, oh, to have no money problems, those people's lives are ideal. When you're disorganized, you feel, oh, if you could just be organized. And so you have fantasies, and it means so much more. It's more loaded an issue for you. So in this young man, when he feels awkward, he feels, oh, no one else struggles with dancing, and I should be perfect. So you have to really reevaluate the yardstick by which you're evaluating yourself and make sure it's not way out of bounds. It's not imposing huge perfectionism measurements on yourself. And always just shoot for excellence and to keep improving rather than this perfection and gauging yourself by, I need to be there, and until I'm there, I'm nowhere. And just concentrate on today and moving forward with things that bring you joy and things that bring you meaning. Let's see if there's another question here that we can move toward today. This person says that hardest part is her language skills and defending herself to her husband. And, you know, that thing about having to defend yourself all the time, again, that comes from this idea that you're not good enough just as you are. And that, again, people are taking their signals from you. When you feel whole and when you feel good enough just the way you are, even though you have challenges, even though you have difficulties, you can remember then that so does your partner and so does everybody. And it might not be ADD, it might even be much more problematic than ADD for you living with somebody else with their own set of issues. So this idea of defending yourself to other people means you haven't accepted yourself. When you accept yourself, you can accept responsibility for things that might affect other people negatively, but you don't ever have to defend who you are just because your brain functions differently than other people. Again, that's our theme for Halloween. Don't scare yourself. And take off that mask a little bit and let people see who you really are. And let's see if we have one more question for today. Well, it's just the same old struggles for people in certain professions like teachers. This person struggles to get all her papers corrected in a timely manner rather than the night before. Now, what happens is, of course, there's strategies for every profession, every situation, living or professional. You need to work on strategies for getting organized. But you have to be careful that your whole life isn't about that. And you have to make sure that you have a balance between the time you spend in working on your organizational problems and on your struggles in this area versus finding time to fill up and have fun and to let yourself have some balance and downtime. And you'll often find that if you do that, some of the other pressures, when you stop pushing your brain beyond its capabilities at a certain point, will refresh and you'll feel renewed and can often find a way to ask for support and to face some of your challenges with more renewed energy. So the message again for Halloween is I wish you a wonderful year, a magical year, and stop scaring yourself and take off that mask a little bit and let people see the wonderful person you are.